wear thongs.
I don't have any ticket. I don't know what to do here.
I always hear somebody, man.
Hey!
Hey,
how are you doing?
Here we go.
Hello, this is Fred Shedd. This is obviously Fred. I'm Ruby. And today we've got Billy and Zac from Hockey Dad.
How's it going?
Honored to be here in the shed. I love it.
We've like been cooking up this little idea that would probably be perfect for like a little jamming space or a studio. Do you want to kind of go into your mental notes there, Fred?
So what we're going to do is we're going to combine your taste buds with your audiometric, you know, pleasures. So to put it really simply,
so
shove an amp in the fridge.
Sounds good.
That's good. Yeah,
basic layman's terms.
Walk up, plug in, grab a beer, sit down, jam. Drink beer.
I kind of want to take on the air.
Yeah, you guys take on the air. Me and Billy take on the fridge.
I'm forever hacking at fridges.
I always look at a fridge and go, I can't wait to just cut into that. What was your usual rig setup?
So mine, initially when we first started playing, I didn't have any like weird setup. I just had a guitar amp. I bought one of those, like a micropog, and it had two outputs, like a dry and a wet output. Had the dry output of that just going through the rest of my guitar pedals into a guitar amp. The dry signal all the way up. And then the lower octave about halfway, and then no high octave. That would go through a bass amp, basically with bass cranked, treble down, just to get like the feel. After that, I added another amp, and then I kind of went to like three guitar amps.
So chasing tone.
Chasing tone, the never-ending chase. So that was kind of how I did it, just a micropog, getting like an octave down through a Sans amp into a decent bass amp. But you kind of had to play guitar in a certain way to make that work. And I think that's like a lot of those early songs were written with that in mind, like, you know, just big bar chords and like pretty simple stuff. So that was kind of how
I used
to play.
Still pretty simple. But yeah.
Yeah, I'm not saying.
Because me and the boys were actually saying the other day that like you have a bit more freedom now, and I noticed going from a three-piece to a four-piece as well, having the freedom to move around a lot more, and I was just wondering if you kind of felt that as being able to move around.
And I think it's also just a freedom just to play a bit quietly, and like because when I had that, my first rig, really, I had the bass stack and then I had a Fender and a Marshall stack. So, like, you couldn't really play quietly, especially with that bass signal coming through all the time. It was just booming and loud. So now, you know, we can just slow everything down and play a bit quieter and have that dynamic between us all.
Another one I've always wondering, how many snares do you reckon you've broken on stage?
Yeah.
Do you keep a record of that?
I haven't really kept a record, but I do have I'm a bit of a hoarder. And I've got like a lot of my old snare skins from just tours that I really liked.
You were going through a few and then you just kept getting thicker and thicker snare skins to last like a tour. And then it got to the point where it was like fucking jumping castle material on a snare drum.
It would just bounce back. You're like, hey, you
are. I just remember seeing like the two upright like sticking out of the snare skin.
I was on the Grinners tour. I think it was up in Townsville. Somewhere.
That would have been the place to do it.
Yeah, I think just had the rum in me and... Yeah, that's just what happens.
The other question I was going to ask, do you guys still jam and how often do you jam?
We've, over the years, I mean, when we first started playing together, Zac was living at his parents' place and that was just where we first started the band, like in a shed as big as
this. Kind of like this. Not as much cool shit in it, but
heaps of shit, but not as much cool shit, yeah. And then we just kind of got lazy when we started touring more. Well, like, you know,
that,
when
that
we
feels
come
like
home,
a jam, like an hour-long jam every time.
Yeah, exactly. And then, like, you come home and you're like, I just want to surf and relax. So I think we kind of got a bit lazy for the past, like, 3 years.
So while you guys are doing a bit of free labour here, I was kind of just wondering what the best local pub in Windang is.
There's one. And it's definitely not the best, but it's there.
One fun fact, that the first hockey puck ever used in existence was made out of a frozen cow shit.
Oh my god! Whoa. Yeah, what? I went to trivia the other night with Sweeney, he was hosting it, and that was a question.
Fuck off, really?
Yeah, swear to god.
What were the early days of Radbar like?
Oh man, well, like, I was severely underage.
Yeah.
So it was pretty, like, illegal for me to be there. Dan started working behind the bar, and that was when we first met him. And then we would ask him to sneak us in the gigs because he was a bit more lenient. It was just always the same. The only thing that was different was like a different coat of paint, like once a month. And that was it.
Right, I reckon this is looking pretty good.
Well, cheers to that, mate.
Yeah. We actually got through it, hey? That was crazy.
Bit sus, eh?
I don't know, he's legit.
He loves to talk, eh?
Yeah, he does.
Oh, hey.
Oh, hey, mate.
Just having a break, having a beer.
Oh, another one.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
Work at 5 o'clock here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sure. Yeah, shit.
Jesus Christ, I'll go back inside. You both better hurry up and get back in here.
Righto.
Fair enough.
Yeah, in a minute. Fucking hell.
Why do you think your music fits into the genre that it is, and what do you think your genre is at the moment?
Yeah. I don't know, that's pretty... yeah.
We try to play different genres all the time.
Yeah.
Like, we'll try to write country songs or blues songs or try to write pop songs, but they all end up sounding like us. We could pump whatever different inspiration or whatever into a song or try and make it sound a certain way, but in the end, it's still going to end up sounding like us playing that.
What's the best backhanded compliment you've gotten?
I don't know, like your dad's mate you haven't seen in a while, and he's like... So you still got that little band thing?
Oh,
the little band.
My son plays a bit of guitar in his bedroom now and again. Good stuff.
Yeah,
cool. Good on him.
You making money or?
Oh, yeah. While we're talking, did you want to do like a little doodle on the fridge over there? We got some markers.
I'll have a go. I mean, I'm more of a computer-based designer, but I'll go hands-on. I got to really think about this one. I want to nail it. I pretty much just did it in school. Hey, I was like, I do like doing art and all that. And then I kind of got into the computer realm and I was like, oh, I'm actually a bit better at computers and drawings. And it's like not even just the record artworks, it's like, you know, like your social media tiles, your this, your that, like there's so much to it. And then, yeah, instead of outsourcing and paying someone else, I just do it for free. Yeah. Slave labor. If you're, are you goofy?
Natural.
Natural, okay, so that means he's going... Backhand.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Because, I can predict what you're about to say. It's like, if God meant we were meant to drive automatic, we'd have been born with one leg.
True. Right, plug this in, Roots. We're going to see if this makes a racket.
Right.
Come on, boys. You're going to be on this.
This thing.
Get this out of the road. Yeah. Right, I'll go and get a Stratocaster. We're going to move one of these things.
Holy shit, here we go. Holy shit!
Let's go.
Yeah, is that on the swivel?
Yeah, it's on the swivel.
Okay, I'm just gonna chuck all that in.
Does this work? Sounds pretty good. You get him. Get a beat.
Which one is it? This one? Holy jelly. That's sick.
This was a pretty crazy first experiment. How many fucking times have you played guitar out of a fridge?
This is how many times have I played guitar? Not many, Harry. Not much at all.
Pretty keen for the debut.
First projects, just smashed it out of the park.
I don't think we're topping this.
No. Shreds, Fred, fridge.
Thanks, Hayes, for fucking coming in, fellas, and being a part of this.
Thanks for having us and putting the fridge in.
You don't have to be here, but cheers, Bill.
Putting the fridge for us.
That kills it. Yeah. All right, probably next week, we'll probably fucking do something else. I don't know.